Tesla has been leading the way for many years, in my opinion, when it comes to full self-driving. But how does full self-driving do not in beautiful sunny California or Texas, where the ideal conditions are always 75 degrees and sunny? What about when it's snowing and visibility is not as good? Can you still use full self-driving? Well, let's give it a shot. This is a Tesla with the brand new version 13.2 full self-driving firmware. Let's see how it does in the Northeast when conditions aren't perfect. All right, so we're gonna make a 3.6 mile trip, which is not very far, but there's a lot that's gonna happen in this trip, including pulling out of a parking lot, merging onto a highway, getting into some traffic, making some roundabouts, and also parking when we get to Costco when we arrive. So you can now start self-driving by being in the parking spot. So I can go like this and say we're ready to go, and it will do its thing. So you can see that it's smartly backing out of the parking spot rather than actually just going through it like I probably would have. And here we go. Let's see what it does. It's going right down the parking lines, which is very, very nice. It's not actually just cutting through the parking lot. Back in the day, that's what it used to do, was cut through the parking lot entirely. Now it's actually being a very nice, cautious, correct driver, which is great. We're getting to the end of it here. There's obviously no stop sign, but it's smart enough to stop anyway and pay attention to what's happening in the road. Okay, so we get into a stop sign here. Make a right-hand turn. It still obviously, for the most part, will do a pretty good stop at a stop sign. It will occasionally just kind of not roll through it, but inch through it like a person would. So we've got a green arrow here at this light. It is gonna go straight, interesting. Okay, so it got a yellow arrow and it slowed down and stopped, which was so kind of it. Now it is inching up a little bit past where you're actually supposed to stop technically, but it's not my fault. Now we have we can make a left, not a left arrow. And as you can see, no problem whatsoever. There's people merging in both directions. Then I have to immediately get to the right to get on this highway. No problem at all. Now we're gonna merge here to get onto the highway. And it's worth noting as you're watching this, it is snowing outside. So not that the road is really covered at all, but it's at least a good representation of the fact that visibility is not, you know, this perfect clear sky. Now this is a fantastic place to do a little test, depending on your opinion, because this is actually probably one of the stupidest designed on-ramps on any highway, where you're basically having a stop sign and you have to just gun it to get out on the highway because there is no merging lane. As you always should when you are using self-driving, especially if you are new to it, like I'm gonna pay a lot of attention obviously to what's happening here. I'm not gonna let it do something stupid. And you should also do the same if you're ever using self-driving, but I am not gonna also intervene unless it does something that obviously it should not do. So in this case here, it's gonna pull up to this stop sign and look onto this merge and have to merge pretty quickly. So you'll see that it's going to come to the stop sign here. I have my foot ready on the brake just in case, obviously. It's looking and has a lot of cars it has to pay attention to, obviously. Now there's a little gap here. Let's see if it decides to make its way, which it does. Accelerates no problem because it's a Tesla. Wow, that's nice. That's really good. That's really impressive. That was a very natural gap. It's right up to speed now at 60 miles an hour on the highway, but it didn't do this abrupt, you know, Model X Plaid launch where it threw you into the back of the seat. It was very natural. It went where I would have went. It wasn't so cautious that it waited for an hour, which is sometimes what self-driving used to feel like it did, where you were just waiting and waiting. And that was really, really nice. If you're from this area, that's not an easy place to merge. That is kind of a spot that a lot of people don't like merging. We're getting off the next exit. We're already in the exit only lane. So it actually is going to the left just to pass this person, which it will then have to go back into the right after that. It's getting off in half a mile, but it was in an exit only lane, which obviously it does see that on signs. So it'll probably very quickly realize it didn't need to necessarily do that. And it's gonna actually have to merge back into this in under a quarter of a mile. So let's see if it does it right in front of this van. That's exactly what it's gonna do. Right behind these buses, very naturally. It slows down very naturally. And it's sometimes hard to tell on camera, but like these movements are extremely natural and smooth feeling right now. They are not jerky. They are confident. They are as though you're the person driving. There's been no abrupt accelerations, abrupt braking. It's been very, very natural. So far, I have not touched the wheel one time. And it's been really, really smooth. And you may be watching this and saying to yourself, like, I don't need my car to drive itself because I like driving and whatever. I can hear the arguments that people already say. People tend to always overreact on these kind of videos by saying, why is that necessary? But part of this whole push, and with Elon's new robo-taxis that he's announced, and years, what he always essentially dreamed and announced would happen, who knows when it will, is that you'd be able to essentially have your normal work day and be at work from 9 to 5 and let your Tesla be like an Uber and a taxi to make you money while you're actually sitting at home, maybe even, or at work. So part of this push and part of what they're doing, which is why it's so important that self-driving is very good, is like their new robo-taxis, for example, they don't even have a steering wheel or pedals. So someone gets in that, they put their destination in, and they just go. There are already self-driving taxis that exist around the country, a couple other companies that are doing them, and you basically get in the back seat of a taxi, you type in your destination, and you literally just sit in the back seat and watch it, which to most people is terrifying because you literally have no control. At least in this, if for some reason it decides to go crazy, I can just, you know, take over. But it's really impressive what they've done. Now, for the sake of this video, because we are going to be in this little line of traffic for probably like 5 or 10 minutes because it's just doing absolutely nothing, we're going to skip forward to just where we get to the next section so that we're not just talking for the next 10 minutes. Now, one important thing to note also is that it does require me to still pay attention. So this is called full self-driving supervised, which basically means I don't have to touch the wheel this entire time, but it's called supervised because it's basically using this front camera here on the Tesla to look at me. So if I pay no attention to what's happening, if I were to fall asleep or I would be doing something or playing with my phone or doing something unsafe while driving, even though it's driving, it will prompt me and it will eventually turn off full self-driving, because it obviously doesn't want you to be able to just fall asleep or take a nap. But I do think we eventually get to a day, probably sooner than later, where it's not gonna need as much of your attention, because honestly, I think that these drive much better than most people actually do. I mean, if you look at most people, when you're driving by most people not using self-driving, they're playing on their phones, they're distracted, they're doing makeup, they're doing all kind of stuff that, like, that feels way less safe to me than if I actually pass by a Tesla and I see someone not really paying attention or not with their hands on their wheel. I know that the Tesla is never going to get tired, it's never going to get drunk, it's never going to be distracted, it has redundancy, and it has a lot of technology into this that really makes it safer. I actually look forward to the day when there is a lot more self-driving vehicles, because when you look at the majority of accidents that happen all over the country, most of them are from people that weren't paying attention. It's not just from people that literally both decided to go at the same time and crash. Like, it's someone runs into the back of a vehicle or someone does something dumb because they're not looking or they're not paying attention. This car won't really do that. And it's just impressive that when we continue to get more and more self-driving vehicles, what will they be able to do by talking to each other, to be able to know in advance when something's slowing down and before it even has to see it on cameras? Can it get it more cleverly talk to the other cars? I'm just excited to see where it goes. But Tesla's no question about it leading that full self-driving revolution. They are the best at doing it, in my opinion. No one even comes close yet. But companies like Waymo, I believe, which is the self-driving taxi that is currently running, they obviously have a lot as well, but their vehicle looks entirely different. So this looks like a more normal vehicle, where that one has crazy cameras all over it. So it's not necessarily going to be like your daily driver. But man, it's pretty sweet. So you will notice that on the screen here, it says full self-driving may be degraded, poor weather detected. So that is something that Tesla will do when it's driving. If it detects, you know, weather every once in a while, sometimes it'll happen with snow because it'll kind of build up on the cameras or the sensors, but it'll usually tell you like that you can't do it. So right now it's having no problem. It's still doing what it needs to do. It just will tell you that like it potentially is going to need to have something done to make sure that the cameras and the sensors, you know, are still doing okay. But now the prompt is off. So it kind of goes on and off depending on how bad the weather is. And it is snowing right now. So all this test we've been doing is, even more impressive because visibility is less than it would be. The other thing that full self-driving does that most people don't do is actually drive when the person in front of them starts to go. That's nice, because I can't stand when I see people at a stoplight not pay attention when the car goes in front of them. So we are now going to pull into Costco here. And the vehicle will actually find a parking spot from what I understand and what I've watched in some videos, but I don't know if it's limited to just certain parking lots or certain settings. I don't know exactly what it is, but we're gonna find out what it does here, or whether it's just gonna basically pull me to the front of the building and then stop. But this is a very busy parking lot. A lot of people, a lot of carts, a lot of cars, a lot of, you know, the craziness of Costco. So it'll probably see pedestrians, it'll see a lot of different things, but let's see if it finds a parking spot for me. I'm thinking maybe it will, because this is, you see how that even very naturally, like, it didn't just slam on its brake when that person was stopping. Another car pulling out here, so let's see if it's gonna make a right-hand turn here somewhere. Okay, here it goes. You'll see that there's a lady here with her cart. Let's hope it doesn't kill her. You can see it's just naturally going around. Look, it's letting her go. She's jogging. So it's, I don't know if it's looking for a spot. It's got to go around this car here, and I look like a moron because I'm basically not. I'm just going to quickly, but it just goes right around her. There's that person there. Autopilot will not break. Okay, so it's not finding a parking spot. I don't know if I have to do that, but that was a full trip. It did really good around that person there. Like, I kind of just naturally got scared, but it went very gracefully around that person with no problem. So yeah, it's pretty impressive to see kind of where we have gotten with full self-driving. As you can see, the visibility is even lower now. It is snowing a little bit harder. Roads are still nice and clear, but no problem whatsoever. I'm really, really impressed with that whole trip, because there are a lot of maneuvers that I feel like my wife can't even do very well. I'm not going to say that too loudly, but this did significantly better than most drivers do, and I'd prefer to have a bunch of Teslas driving around in autopilot and full self-driving than when I watch certain people drive. So yeah, pretty cool to see the progress we're making. Makes me kind of want to get another Tesla. And oh, by the way, this is my friend's Tesla. Tom, appreciate you, my friend, for letting me use it. I have awesome friends that just unlocked their Tesla and let me drive it in the snow without paying attention to the road. Thanks for watching. I would love to know your thoughts. Are you a Tesla owner? Are you interested in Teslas? I'm getting more and more into just the tech behind cars and car reviews and all that. We are getting to a point as we continue to progress in vehicles where these things are computers that are driving around, really, that just so happen to have tires and and batteries on them. And cars are getting better and better because of technology. It's crazy to think that all you just saw in this car over these full self-driving miles did not exist when this car was purchased. And how many cars can you say improve as you own them? So of course you have naturally some loss of money when a car is brand new and you drive it off a lot. Like, we get that side of it, but these vehicles are getting better and better with software updates, not just Teslas, but basically any vehicles and a lot of the EVs. Like, they are improving as the companies do more testing and put out new software updates, which is awesome. Because like, this car didn't drive itself when it was purchased, I think maybe 2 years ago. And now it drives itself this well because of a software update. Like, that's crazy. You couldn't do that in the past. So yeah, pretty impressive, Tesla. You're doing some pretty good things. Thanks for watching. And I'm just gonna take a nap now, let this thing drive me home.